Everything looks all right. So without further ado, let's play some LA Noir. I'm excited about it. Oh, can I go in? All the cases are in there. The DLC cases are in there. Just if that's what you're wondering.
A city on the verge of greatness. A new type of city, based not on the man, but on the automobile. The car, the symbol of freedom and vitality.
Oh, I think I know why it's suddenly... Okay, we're going to have to do window capture on this instead of game capture. I know why it stopped showing. It's not a big deal.
The city where a man's home is his castle. A quarter acre of the dream made possible by victory.
I'll check once we're... Once we're through this cutscene. This 30 FPS cutscene. Ugh.
The city of dreams. Where Hollywood will shape the thoughts and desires of the entire planet. City of pioneers.
Hollywood Land. I think they probably could have gotten away with using the name Hollywood. What did it used to say Hollywood Land, maybe? Like way back in the day?
The city of dreamers.
Oh, their faces are so weird.
City of undercurrents, where not everything is as it seems. A 20th century city that will become a model for the world.
I also hope that eventually the black bars, like I hope this is just cinematic, and it'll eventually go back to full screen. I can see. Because that would be a little annoying. Upon reflection,
mistakes get made, but you deal with them. You know what you're fighting for, and that you're on the same team. But dealing with corruption is like chasing shadows.
I don't think it is going to go all full screen.
The guy you're talking to is on the pad, or whether it's your partner, or maybe even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGBL calling car 14 Adam. 14 Adam.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective at ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street. Unit 16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
We're on it.
Roger, 14 Adam en route.
Yep, we're on it. Oh, it does go full screen. Sweet. No, but apparently Hollywood Land is an actual film crime biography about real life mysteries. Ooh, I might have to look into that. All right, let's see if we can make subtitles a little bigger. If not, eventually it... Yeah, it doesn't look like... Maybe interface size? Y'all think that might... That looks ugly, though. I doubt interface size changes the size of the subtitles, though. I think that's just, like, your HUDs and stuff. You can be in black and white if you want. Look, it doesn't look like I get options to make subtitles bigger. So it looks like cutscenes, y'all just have to, like, squint your eyes really, really tight and see if you can see anything. But then everything should be fine here.
Ever the optimist, from the beam of sunshine himself.
I guess I'm going to this yellow thing down here. Alleyway crime scene, 10:10 p.m. How does everything sound, by the way? Everything good?
Rose, homicide. You might back up?
Yes, sir. Phelps and Dunn, Wilshire Division.
We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue. Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece.
All righty.
I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
We got it.
Wants to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a low life. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
You say GTA, no running over folks? Where's the fun in that?
Technical services.
Hurry up, Floyd. We
I'm
got places
here.
To be.
Happy hunting.
Turn it up a bit, or maybe it's your volume that you have on low. Rusty, how's it sound for you?
This is a fist hump. Just going through the motions.
Probably right.
Let's just get it over and done.
Just curious.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to
the voice volume is low compared to the music. Oh, that's just how the game is.
And we'll talk it out. Two heads are always better than one.
Well, I can actually fix that. Let's see, sound. I can turn music just a touch down. And then dialogue should go above the music. You would think. Yeah. That should help you guys out. See, if I turn everything up, then it'll drown out my voice. And my voice is the moneymaker. That's a joke. Search locations thoroughly to discover clues. It was a cold, dark night in Hollywoodland.
Look at this junk.
Look at this junk. Always look in the trash can. They may have thrown a piece away in the trash can. A body.
It's not my job to pick through other people's trash.
What is it? Oh, there could be fingerprints on this thing. Use WASD to manipulate an object. Okay. I don't think there's anything wrong with this bottle. Nah, just a bottle. Somebody's been drinking back here. We got a newspaper right here. Shrink says the mind is the final frontier. Oh, can I pick up the newspaper? Hold up, I'm reading the newspaper, man. Shrink says the mind is the final frontier. Press thing to see the story behind the headline. Okay. Oh, I'm using mouse and keyboard, so we'll just have to go off of sound.
Dr. Fontaine, could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, doctor. Psychiatry seems to have a tremendous amount to offer.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work. The mind is the last great mystery in medicine. Are you thinking of specializing, Mr.
Sheldon. Courtney Sheldon. I'm only in second year, doctor. They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war.
Ah.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
This guy's weird, this doctor.
Battle fatigue and collapse under duress. Can it be helped?
I would say yes, given the right set of circumstances. Trauma forces the mind to close down, retreat in on itself. We try to find ways to unlock the mind again through a combination of therapy and drug treatment. Hypnosis and therapy are powerful tools in the right hands, Sheldon.
I've been to visit some of the guys at the VA hospital. A good friend of mine, he's so far away. It's like he's wandering.
You went through a lot together.
Yes, doctor.
Give me his details and I'll make a prognosis. I have a number of clinics in Los Angeles, Courtney Sheldon. And your penance for your friend's help is to come and work at one of them in your spare time, with what little spare time a medical student has. Is that a deal?
Is it ever? I can't thank you enough.
I'm not promising a cure, Courtney. I want you to remember that. Every physician has patients that he cannot hope to cure, for whom he can only smooth the path to death.
I'm betting that guy is a murderer. I have no reason to believe that, but he's just really weird, and I think we're going to come across him at some point. Nobody tell me that, by the way. That's just me. That's me prognosticating. Dr. Harlan Fontaine speaking at USC. All right, let's put it down. Sorry, partner. I was just reading the newspaper. Oh, somebody might be doing some kind of SOSing through that window up there. Insta-heat, have hot water, 24 hours a day. Hang on, partner, I'm gonna check up the stairs just in case he threw something up the stairs, okay? Facial capture expressions are still dead. Yeah, it's really, really good. It's a little creepy. I think if I had played this back in the day, my mind would have been blown. It looks a little bit creepy, not gonna lie, but I'm sure back in the day I would have been blown away. Trash can? No. Anything up here? No. Oh, there might be something up here. You gotta be thorough. As a police officer in the 19-whatevers, you gotta be thorough. It's very important. bum bum. Okay, here we go. There's blood. Blood spatter analysis we need to do. 1940s, okay.
Hell of a way to go.
Doesn't really matter how you go once you're gone.
Don't get all deep on me, Phelps.
All right, so this man was shot right here. His brains went against the wall. There you go. It's up there.
Ralph, there's something on the rooftop.
It was called Hollywoodland. Oh, interesting.
Reflection in the window. Looks like it might be our weapon. I'm gonna see if I can find a way up there.
All right, don't hurt yourself.
That lighting looks really bad, by the way. But again, it was years and years ago. Let's see if we can find anything else. Yeah, that's just a beer bottle and a bum was living there.
The gun's up on the roof, right? So we need to find a way up.
Hold up. Oh, I found something. I found a formerly lit cigarette. Maybe we can do some 1940s DNA analysis on this.
What kind of chumps do these homicide guys think we are?
I don't think that there's, like, really good fingerprint analysis or DNA analysis at this point, so... Oh my god, I'm climbing up this pole. Alright, I guess we're trying to find the gun. It's up here somewhere. Oh, there it is.
Found it yet?
Yeah, I got it. It's a gun. It is most definitely a gun. WSD to manipulate an object and search for points of interest. Oh, there we go.
Smith & Wesson, serial S71893.
Yep. Cole Phelps is played by Aaron Staton, who is Ken Cosgrove. Yeah, he looks familiar. Yeah, that looks right.
Two rounds fired, and instead of dropping it down a drain, our shooter hoists it up here. Interesting guy.
Yeah, but why? Can I keep the gun?
We should follow up on this now, before the perp tries to leave town.
Found clues will be added to your notebook. It said music would stop when all clues are found. I feel like we haven't found all clues yet. There's still music being played. Let's see what we got. We got a bloodstain and a Smith & Wesson revolver. Smith & Wesson revolver, serial number S71893, two rounds fired. People. Scooter Payton. Negro male murder victim shot twice point blank. Murder suspect. Tall Caucasian male described by witness. Detective Floyd Rose. Homicide investigator first on scene of shooting. Okay, locations. Alleyway crime scene. Case objectives. Find who murdered man. Okay. Alright, I think we're good. I mean, there's still music, so I don't understand. Like, they said the music would stop. That means he did it since he was the first one at the scene? Definitely.
Let's take it back to Central. We could get a commendation.
We could show some initiative, Ralph. See if we can come up with an owner.
That's a long shot, Cole.
It's a pretty fancy gun. You know a local gun store?
Sure. There's a place a couple of blocks from here.
Okay, I guess we're going a couple of blocks from here. Let's check the area, though. I feel as though there's more music to... Maybe that just means there's more clues in this case, because they're definitely telling me to go somewhere else. Locations... Gun store. That's where we're gonna go.
Are you sure about this? It's not really our gig.
No harm in doing some digging. The suits didn't seem to give much of a damn.
Such a little Boy Scout, Cole. You can't wait to get out of that uniform, can you?
You'd rather round up drunks and help old ladies across the road?
I'd rather get through the day without the captain's foot up my ass.
It'll be fine, Ralph. You worry too much.
I don't think there's any more clues, but I don't understand why they said the music would stop if you have no more clues. But there's definitely still music going on. Trucking area, no parking. Okay, let's go. To the squad car! Oh, hey. Oh, I bet you one of these people knows something. Hey, weird old man. Why do all these people wear overalls? Was that like 1940s? Did everyone wear overalls in the 1940s? Oh, ma'am, let me help you cross the street. I am a police officer. Hey, stop. There's a lady coming across the street. I got you, ma'am. All right. We did our good duty today. I feel good about that. I am a good man. All right. Dude, there's no, like, they don't tell you, like, the path to go on. You just have to find the flag on the mini-map. That's gonna be kind of weird. H to use the siren. Yeah! I don't want to do that. I mean, we're not, like, having to rush after a suspect or anything. F to ask your partner for directions. Really? You want me to go left? Partner, that's an offense.
Take the next right.
Yeah, make up your mind. You said go left. Now you're saying go right?
Take the next left.
Ooh.
Take the next left.
Hey. We're not trying to get in a wreck over here.
Take the next right.
Okay. He's just as bad as a chick when it comes to directions, it's true.
Next left.
Okay, I'm going left. A great force in a great city. Join now a job to be proud of. The police.
Stop just ahead.
Okay. Central Guns. I bet you that's where we're going. Gun store, 10:32 p.m. Me and my dick partner. We're going to search for who bought this gun with this serial number. Bet you it was that guy. That guy shot him. He took one of his own guns and shot a man in cold blood.
Officers Phelps and Dunn, can you tell us anything about this gun?
Smith & Wesson, Model 27, registered Magnum. Chambered for .357, nickel-plated with pearl grips. Same gun used by General Patton.
You're not suggesting he's the owner?
No, I'm not.
You seem to know a lot about the weapon.
I ought to. I sold it. You know this piece will stop a rhino. These babies?
Will it though?
Available special order.
Really?
Here's my Smith & Wesson order book.
You mind if I take a look?
Be my guest.
Be my bad, right? Guest. Be my guest. Open a ledger.
Model 27 with pearl grips, Cole. You see it on there?
Oh my god. I got a 27 nickel checkered walnut grip. Uh-oh, I don't remember what he told me. 27, something about a nickel grip. No, that ain't it. Oh, here we go. Polished nickel.
We're in luck. Errol Schroeder, 203 South Glass Street.
Pearl grip, polished nickel.
46. Thanks, you've been a big help.
I'm doing some good police working, man.
Always happy to help out the LAPD.
Oh my god, I'm an amazing police officer. Did this duck commit the murder? Where were you on the night of 1942? No. Normally you have to get a warrant. Not all objects are relevant to your... Oh, you're telling me that duck ain't relevant? He's looking a little suspicious. Hey, Energy, what's up, buddy? How you doing? Tell me this duck don't look suspicious. All right. I'm going to do a little bit more searching. Detective Llama on the case. Hey, Dr. Boo. Welcome back, buddy. I'm doing all this. I probably don't need to search anything else. But we're going to be very thorough police officers. Who you got tonight? Nets or Bucks? You know what? My brain says the Nets win at home. But I'm going to go out on a limb and I'm going to say the Bucks win. They get a upset on the road. Wouldn't be much of an upset. Nets are only 2-point favorites. But I think the Bucks are going to make it happen. I think they figured out something in game 6. And I'm going to say that they shocked the world.
Can we call it in?
Let's see if he's at home. Owning the gun doesn't prove he pulled the trigger.
That is true.
Okay. In for a penny, in for a pound. Lead the way, Gunga Din.
What the hell does that mean? In for a penny, in for a pound. I think my partner killed the person. Uh-oh, I forgot what button.
Turn left.
Oh, here we go. God, I'm the worst police officer of all time. Oh, God. Okay, we're all right. What about Islanders Lightning? I don't know anything about hockey. I would say the Lightning. Oh, my God, I'm driving on it. I don't think this is where my partner wanted me to go. Partner, you want to help me out with the directions here? Oh.
Go straight over.
Go straight over.
So hard,
okay.
Just because we're in uniform doesn't mean we can't use our initiative. You need to take the next left.
Okay.
Take the next left.
I guess so. Seems a little too good to be true. One-of-a-kind murder weapon bought locally using a real name. If Schroeder's our shooter, he's no criminal mastermind.
Most of them aren't.
Woo!
When
you played this, you somehow didn't pay attention enough. Notice you can shoot in the air when chasing people. You murdered every suspect. Oh my God. So you were like the real life police. Oh man.
Stay on this road.
Okay.
Keep going on this road. Go straight over the intersection.
All right, I'm going, partner. I got a need for speed. See, we've been watching Fast and the Furious. You saw how I just wove in and out of traffic? I learned that.
Go straight.
Yeah. Oh.
Keep going on this road.
Okay.
Take this left.
Hey, Steve. Yeah, new computer, man. Get to stream in 1080p. Again, y'all, if you have connection issues, we do have quality options. Just lower the quality option. You can go to, like, 720 or 480, whatever you need to do. But with the new computer, it doesn't make much sense for me not to stream at 1080 since we can. Moxley's. Ooh, John Moxley has a 1940s apparel shop. Probably wouldn't want to dress like him. With how outlandish the stunts have gotten, do you think at this point we could borderline consider Fast and Furious a fantasy series? I think you could, yeah. I love them, though. I'm really enjoying them. All we have left is Hobbs and Shaw. We'll do that on Friday. And then the new movie comes out this week. A chime or a magnifying glass icon indicates objects nearby. Well, we knew that already. Schroeder? Yeah.
Schroeder. Apartment 2.
Okay. We're going to apartment 2. Come on, partner. I mean, we don't have an arrest warrant. We don't have a search warrant. But this is the 1940s where we don't have to follow the law. Alright, here we go. Open up! This is the police!
What do you guys want?
I'm Officer Cole Phelps. This is Officer Dunn. Wilshire Division. You're the owner of a Smith & Wesson Model 27, nickel-plated with pearl grips?
I might be. What of it?
Then you'll be surprised to know that Scooter Payton was murdered tonight with your gun.
You're out of your mind. Scooter? He works for me. I have that gun here in my drawer.
Oh, do you now?
What the fuck is going on here?
You're under arrest, Schroeder. Cuff him, Ralph.
No way.
Wait, I think somebody stole his gun. I think that's pretty clear. Oh my God, we're fighting this guy. Oh my God. Okay. Space to block. Well, I didn't block. I kind of just ducked. I'm like Floyd Mayweather. You can't touch me. Floyd Mayweather disaster. There you go. Yeah. Damn. I'm good at fighting.
Ralph, you all right?
I'm fine. I hardly felt it. He's lucky he caught me off guard.
Okay, I guess we can search apartments now.
Keep an eye on him, Ralph.
What was he having for dinner there? We found those beers on the scene! I think that's just because it's probably a generic beer bottle, but... Alright, he likes his boxing. He's actually a huge fan of boxing. Look at this. He's got boxing gloves, trophies, maybe he was a championship boxer. I hope not, because I just kicked his ass with no training. But he tried. God bless him, he tried. What about the dresser he opened? Oh, we're definitely searching that. I'm just searching the rest of his apartment first. Oh my god, why did you don't... Dude, he's handcuffed. You don't have to... Well, he's kind of handcuffed. I mean... There's no actual chain between the links of the handcuffs. But he's kind of handcuffed. Actually... I mean, look at that. There's no chain in between the handcuffs. Partner. These handcuffs are not going to work on this situation. He could just get up and start trying to box us again. Maybe that's why he's pointing his gun at him. Ooh, a Playboy. Oh no, Mystic Tales. The chain is in the coat? Those two pieces right there are not tied together. No, it can't be in his coat because both of his hands are on top of his coat. There's just no chain on the thing. Comic book. Oh, this must be like a collectible of some kind. Mystic Tales. Yeah, but can I read it? No. He doesn't do his dishes very well.
Doesn't look like anything.
No. Oh, an apple. This will prove my case.
Nope.
Why does he have an apple on the ground? Llama has a new case investigating the handcuffs. Yeah. They're not working, clearly. They don't have a chain on them. All right, what do you got up in here? Some names, some dates. Is this a hit list? Oh, Floyd Rose.
A series of numbers. Floyd Rose's name is in this book.
Phelps, we can come out of this all bright and shiny.
Wasting a perfectly good apple.
Or stick our schlongs in a hornet's nest.
Well, we don't need to do that.
Come in, partner, and leave the book where you found it.
Well, I didn't find it there. I found it in the drawer.
That's 1247 requesting.
I feel like we broke a lot of laws as police officers. Hey, Biggs. Maybe not 1940s laws. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, cutscenes go down to about 30 FPS.
Excuse me, Sergeant, but...
Excuse me? Fuck you! You say another word and I'll break your fucking head and have you in the brig.
Some of us are here for...
I know why you're here, asswipe. I'm having a bad day, Private. Some people don't seem to want to get on this bus.
Didn't ask for your help.
He didn't ask for your help. Can you believe this guy? Who are you two? Abbott and Costello?
We're here for OCS, Sergeant.
So it's the three fucking stooges and you're here for OCS. God help this fucking country and the USMC. The Japanese will do the world a favor and kill you quickly. All three of you are on report. What are your fucking names?
Phelps.
Kelso.
Merrill.
This reminds me of Full Metal Jacket.
OCS? OCS is at Elliott. You take the Camp Elliott bus over there. This bus is for MCRD. This bus is for men who want to fight.
I want to fight. Oh, man, we're peons. I don't think we got off to a good foot with this guy.
Armed and Dangerous World Premiere.
A city that needed an honest cop like a thirsty man needed water. You'd heard the stories, but you weren't interested. You were here to fight the good fight, solve cases, right wrongs. The force is like politics. There's no sitting on the fence. You have to choose sides. A brown paper envelope, or a Greyhound ticket to Palookaville. It could only ever end one way.
All units at 211 in progress and shots fired at Westlake Savings and Loan.
Oh, we've got a case. Is the Dom Cam in 40K? Yes. What's up, Asdos? Can I get a shout out from my boy Asdos? Definitely go check him out.
We'll handle the 211.
Get to stream in 1080, which is nice. At least with most games. I'm sure we'll come across a game where maybe I'm not able to, but... Oh, it's nice, man. And I'm only at like 20% CPU. It's insane. It's insane how good. By the way, if anybody needs, if anybody is curious about the specs, I got it down in my panels. Oh, we got a shootout, boys. Westlake Savings and Loans, 9:19 a.m. I think these guys are guilty, if I had to guess. Oh, dear God. Okay. Oh, you're about to die, boy. Feel my wrath. We take no prisoners here. Bro, I shot the dude right in the head. Come on, show yourself. I guess he has to pop up. All right, let's reload. You gonna pop up?
Now.
Hey, buddy, you want to... There we go.
Keep your goddamn head down. Use the cover, though. You don't know how many are in there. Take it slow. Backup will be here soon.
Oh, he's up there. Oh, just all over the walls, the blood and
That's
guts
it.
And gore.
We got them all? I think we got them, Cole.
I think I got them. Oh, I got shot in the back. Oh, I better get a purple heart
Lieutenant
for that.
Hopkins says anytime you reach for the shotguns, you're either going to end up dead or wearing a citation. So I guess...
It's okay, Ralph. You did well in there. I'm glad you had my back. Man couldn't ask for a better partner.
Well, I kind of disagree. I could have had a better partner that actually shot somebody. I got shot in the back because of his inaction. It's just really weird. You go from smoothness of 60 and then the cutscenes are just like super choppy, but I guess that's
this
just
kind
the
of
game.
Opportunity comes along once in a lifetime, Hank. I have to grasp it.
Can you get a refund?
I'm
going to put in a chargeback with PayPal.
If I can make a name for myself in this war, my future.
Thinking of taking on a company of the Emperor's finest single-handed? You don't seem the Sergeant York type to me.
When I need your opinion, Kelso, I'll ask for it.
Yeah.
They talk about officers like you in boot camp, Cole. They call it the Custer Syndrome. Guys who go around dreaming of fame and glory and getting all of their men killed in the process.
Our duty is to lead, Kelso.
And their duty is to die for your wonderful future?
Maybe I just dream in 30 FPS.